Good evening. My name is Dorte Riemschneider, and I have the privilege of saying a few words on behalf of the European Citizen Science Association at the end of this EXA conference 2020, alongside with Luigi Ceccaroni and Enrico Balli. In my opening remarks, I mentioned that this conference will take the form of an online experiment, something which is quite new and special for EXA. I was surprised that in some ways this online conference was so similar to an on-site event. When I read the program, I thought, I would like to see this lecture. Oh, and this parallel session as well. And here, this one, it's already over. Too bad. And I still have to prepare my own talk, and actually I need a break. Don't worry if you felt the same way. What you missed or even want to see again is available to all conference participants for sure until Sunday. Maybe Enrico can clarify on this. Along with the fantastic and impressive high-quality citizen science content of this conference, we had a live band, Zoom yoga to relax in between, and many great recipes for the social lunch breaks to remind us of the spirit of Trieste. It was a pleasure to participate. Also, for sure, it's still not the same as meeting in person. We would like to know what you think. We are interested in receiving both positive feedback and criticism. Your suggestions for how to make it better next time are much appreciated. Maybe someone can also share the link of the Padlet in the chat. I'm very happy to see a wide range of different people at this conference. Many presentations from great women, from older and very young people, and from all across the globe. The European Citizen Science Association wants to be open to all people, and with the support of the EXA Working Group on Empowerment, Inclusiveness, and Equity, we want to become more diverse. This October, we will hold an online workshop on this topic, and you are warmly invited to participate. The exact dates will be shared soon. The end of the EXA Conference 2020 is the beginning of the preparation for the EXA Conference in 2022. And I would like to invite everyone to think about hosting our upcoming conference. If you are thinking about becoming a host, you can contact me or one of my colleagues directly for more information. I would like to thank all of those who brought this conference to life. The keynote speakers, all session chairs, all presenters of workshops, all those who took part in discussions, and especially all conference participants, for being open to this experiment, for listening, for writing in the chat, or simply reading along, for getting involved in this online format. You have made this conference a huge success. I hope that this conference has helped to advance citizen science, that we have built up resources and networks together. I hope that what we are developing as a citizen science community will increase our power to change our worlds and our own behaviors. Thank you very much for listening. I hand over to Luigi now.
Hello. Okay, you should be able to see my screen now. So this is Luigi. Together with Muki, I'm one of the co-vice chairs of EXA. Thanks, Dorte, for the introduction. Let me start with another big thank you to Enrico, his team, and everybody who worked behind the scenes. Enrico will talk just after me, and he will close the conference in the best possible way. But let me just go with a couple of announcements. So as you have seen, this year, the conference is not associated with the General Assembly of EXA. The General Assembly is very important. It is a very important event that is, of course, not a scientific event, but it's an event that for an association is critical because a lot of decisions need to be made. So what will happen in the General Assembly? We will have a decision to be made about our governance bodies. So we will have election of the board, of the chairs, and of the advisory board. So everybody is invited to be a candidate for this. So we will send out a call for candidates before the elections. The assembly will be November 27th. So there is time. So get prepared and please let's try to make also the governance bodies of EXA as diverse as possible. So it's very important at the moment, the board, the chairs, it's middle-aged white people, most of them. So let's try to make a change and have a diversity of people also in the bodies of governance of the association. Of course, we will talk about the working groups. We need to confirm and propose new working groups. We will vote for new statutes that will change possibly the structure of this governance structure of the association. And we have to vote and hopefully approve the budget of the association. The other announcement is about the future conferences. So conferences are there all the year and every year. The EXA conference is one of the main conferences of citizen science around the world, but of course there are other very important conferences. And in particular, we have the Citizen Science Conference in the US next year. So it's in May. I think it's a hybrid at the moment, so it could be in Phoenix, Arizona, and online. Things might change, of course. And with respect to Australia, the CITSAI Oz will be online. Also, things can change. I'm sure that our Australian colleagues will announce possibly new parallel events next year. But for the moment, what is confirmed is that in October this year, every Wednesday, there will be a session of the Australian Citizen Science Conference. And in Austria, Austria, Europe, we have next week, September 14th, 16th, the conference of the Citizen Science Network Austria. And finally, we have in Switzerland, in January, CITSAI Helvetia, January 14th, 15th. And to conclude the event session, once again, I can tell you that in October it's confirmed that we have a hybrid conference in Berlin, Germany, the 14th and 15th of October. And this is a conference dedicated to the interlink between citizen science and SDGs. So, this was about events. I will now give the floor to Enrico for the conclusion of the conference from the organization point of view. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Luigi. It's our last session before the disco party. We have spent quite a few days together. We started the conference last Sunday, and since then we've been experimenting a new format of conference, a completely new social environment. It has been not only an honor, but a pleasure to host the conference ECSA 2020 in Trieste, even if the conference was online. It was, as I said, quite a big experiment. And apparently, the experiment gave us good results. Apparently, everybody's satisfied and happy with our conference. I'm personally very satisfied. It has been quite a demanding task to organize the conference. It has been quite challenging to move the conference online, but I have to say that during these 5 days, we all have met old colleagues, new colleagues, friends, friends and people from so many different countries, from many different continents. I think that this wouldn't have been possible without the online conference. I was really amazed the very first day when we discovered from how many different countries the people was connecting to our conference. As I told you, it hasn't been easy. We have been working quite a lot, but it has been a very nice experience. So I would like to repeat the invitation of Dorte to other organization to candidate for the next conference in 2022, knowing that hopefully the conference will take place physically, but if not, we know that we can anyway meet and work together online. Now, I have to thank a lot of people, so it will last a while. Let me start with the co-organizer of the Trieste conference, University of Trieste, and Stefano Martellos, who unfortunately couldn't join us this evening for the closing session of the conference. University of Trieste has been physically hosting the Trieste team during all these days, and we have been working in a very nice place, and I really want to thank Stefano to have provided all the facilities and the connectivity and everything else that was needed to manage the conference during these 4 days. And then, obviously, I have to thank EXA. It has been quite a long work together. We started more than 1 year ago to work for the organization of the conference. And, well, it was a wonderful opportunity to meet people we didn't know, work with wonderful people, and to put together what we experienced in the last 4 days. So let me start with the people of EXA who have been working hard in the last many months for the organization of the conference, starting with Margaret and Barbara and Simone and obviously Dorte and Luigi that you have just seen on stage, but also Tim and Muki. So I would like to have Tim and Muki together with me on the stage. Thank you very much, Tim. What you've done during the last year has been invaluable. And it was nice to work together with you. And I hope that we will have the opportunity to do something together in the future inside the association. So thank you very much, Tim. And a very special and warm thank you to Muki Aklay. I have to admit that without Muki, we couldn't have had such a wonderful program, such a wonderful content for our conference, such beautiful keynotes and such beautiful sessions. Muki, without you, the conference wouldn't have been the same. So a very warm thank you. And it was really a pleasure to work with you during the last many months. Thank you very much. And now I have to go to our sponsors. And obviously the conference has a cost, and our sponsors and institutional partners have been very helpful in letting us organize these 4 days. Let me start with the institutional partners, the Municipality of Trieste and the regional government of Friuli Venezia Giulia, I would like to thank our mayor, Riccardo Di Piazza, and the president of the region Friuli-Venezia Giulia, Massimiliano Ferriga. Then we have two more partners that have been really, really helpful. The first one is ICTP, the CIFAB Lab of ICTP, the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics. Thank you very much, Carlo. It has been really nice to have the opportunity to work with you. And Trieste Città della Conoscenza. Trieste Città della Conoscenza is a partnership among all the scientific and research institutions of Trieste. And tonight, Trieste Città della Conoscenza will be the physical host of the disco party, by the way. And I would like to thank the Ministry of Education and Research of the Trieste Municipality, Angela Brandi. Then let's go for the sponsors. I have obviously to thank our diamond sponsor, JCOM, the Journal of Science Communication, that really contributed a lot to the organization of the conference, and we'll publish the proceedings of our conference in a few months. I really cannot tell you how long it will take to collect the proceedings, to review them and to publish them, but we will publish them. And I would like to thank our editor-in-chief, Emma, and two of the editors of JCOM, who were organizing the JCOM lunch a couple of days ago, Luisa and Maria. Now we have three gold sponsors, and I would like to thank Museo di Storia Naturale della Maremma and Andrea, obviously. And I would like to thank the Museum for Naturkunde. I would like to thank the director of the museum, Johannes, and the EU Citizen.Science project. All of them have been really precious in helping us to organize the conference. Then we have two silver sponsors, the Crowd for SDG project, who organized a lunch as well, and Illy Cafe, who provided us with all the coffee that we had during our coffee breaks during the conference, all the coffee that you have found in your conference bags. So thank you very much, Illy Coffee. And we have also two bronze sponsors that have been helping us and contributed a lot to the conference. The first one is Spotteron. Thank you very much, Philip. And the second one is Eppinger. Eppinger, who provided us with the very good sweets from Trieste that we enjoyed together during our coffee breaks. So after the sponsors and the organizer of the conference, it is now time to thank all the people that have been working here in Trieste, all the organizing team in Trieste. And let me start with our partner, Equipe, Sonia and Gianni and Federico, Greta, Christian, Simone and Alice. Most of you have met them, all the speakers have met some of them during these days. They've been in charge of providing all the services that have been extremely important in order to stream all the content of the conference. And by the way, thanks to their collaboration, the content of the conference will stay online, available to all the participants until the end of the month. So until the end of September, everybody can watch all the sessions on demand, just clicking on the link on the website. And I think that this is also a very nice service that we can provide. So thank you very much, Equipe. And then the MediaLab team. MediaLab is a small organization, actually, and quite a large fraction of this organization participated to the conference. And so let me start with Martino and Uriel. You all have met them in the social room and the event room during these days. Thank you very much, Martino. Thank you very much, Uriel. And then I have to thank our technical staff in Trieste, Mick and Alessandro, that provided us with all the technical equipment and connection to the internet, fixing an unbelievable amount of problems. So thank you very much, Mick and Alessandro. And also our administration, because as I told you, we are quite a small organization, and the administration of the conference has been much bigger in terms of invoices and payments than what we're usually doing during 1 year. So thank you very much, Tiziana. Thank you very much, Donatella. And I have obviously to give a very warm thank you to the Trieste team that have been together with me and together with you during these 4 days. So I would like to have them all on stage, if possible. Okay. So I could speak for hours about what you've done during this month, what you've done during these days, in which way you have been working for the success of the conference. But I think that I can limit my talk to a very, very, very warm thank you. So thank you, Monica. Thank you, Simona. Thank you, Dorina, and thank you, Francesca. Without you, all this work wouldn't have been possible at all. So I hope that everybody will join this evening the disco party. We will start at 9 sharp, and the DJs already arrived in Trieste. As I told you, we will live stream the disco party on Zoom tonight, and this will be the final event, the farewell party of our conference. Let me thank all the participants, all the speakers, all the chairs of the different sessions, and everybody who decided to spend some time in Trieste, even if virtually. Thank you very much, and ciao from Trieste.